Fallout 3 is one of those games that addicted me to itself by mostly just exploring the following 3-in-1 review. Cost me an extra, I'd say around 10 hours of my life. And it was awesome! Yeah, you can definitely see that I'm gonna be very lazy today. So let's just get it over with. The first DLC is called Operation Anchorage, and it starts out by you, the player, receiving a radio signal transmission from the Brotherhood Outcasts. Apparently they need your help. A few super mutant brain splatters later, you discover that they found an armory filled with some nice new toys for you. If they could get it open, that is. And that's where you come in. Since you're the only one who can actually interface with the simulation machine that needs to be run through in order to unlock it. And what happens in this training simulation? The liberation of the Alaskan city of Anchorage, and thus comes the name Operation Anchorage. And it's the first DLC of this 3-in-1 review I'll be doing. Once you enter the simulation pod, you are warned that if you die in the simulation, you die for real. Considering what's on the outside, you're used to it and hop in just for the hell of it. You start the mission out by one of your fellow covert ops friends, or at least in the simulation, who tells you that you can go in stealthy or guns blazing. Since the first time I did this, I accidentally went in guns blazing without even knowing it. But I redeemed myself by stabbing the guy in the second time. Both of which are fun, but most probably went in guns blazing anyways. On the way, you learn a bit more on what is happening and collect suitcases full of info. Although they don't seem to do much, the DLC is pretty linear, which means that you will be going through a lot of corridors and trenches, killing the red Chinese instead of raiders and the occasional super mutant this time around. A nice little addition to the game is that at least you can choose who you want to take with you in your squad and what weapons loadout you want. There's 3 overall objectives to destroy, but you will find out about that soon enough. The game also offers a bit of a look as to how things were before the nukes hit. Even if it was in snowy Alaska, you will be rewarded with shiny new toys. Stealth ninja armor, anybody? Yeah, thought so. Okay, on moving from the snowy cold Alaska to a lot warmer place, such as a steel mill, we're off to become slaves at the pit. No, seriously, although you're not there cause they captured you, you came to them. Why did you go there to become a slave? To help save the other slaves, apparently. You get another radio message, this time from an escaped slave. Afterwards, you learn that you have to travel to hell on earth, Pittsburgh. The pit. But there's an additional reason to go there as well. Apparently, there's a cure that might, you know, cure any sort of mutation. As soon as you enter the pit, you, at least I did, hated them, which is an excellent since. Actually, I hated the raiders, the guards. They're pricks. And that's excellent, since Fallout 3 always has an excellent atmosphere, and if they can make the captors real bastards that you will hate, then someone has done their job right. The slavers aren't the only things the DLC has done right. The atmosphere is still there, and it's excellent. Especially the working plan of the city, the steel mill, also has its uses. Turns out you can forge bullets if you want to there. There's also a side quest where you have to collect steel ingots and, you know, watch out for those ugly trogs, which are basically this part of the entire game's version of the ghouls, I suppose. Only a lot more vulnerable to ROX to the face! Yeah, I was waiting to say that. You collect these steel ingots early on in order to actually, you know, get something. Because getting them early early on can make the rest a bit easier, since you get something for every 10 ingots you bring in. Later on, you will face off in the arena of your choice to get to Asher and the Cure. Speaking of Asher, his armor kinda makes my character look a bit like Gordon Freeman, although with some skulls attached. You know, that's just my opinion. Luckily, the slavers are pretty dumb and apparently didn't see that you're clearly a survivor, so from collecting the steel ingots to fighting in the arena, they will get theirs. Or will they? Hey, it's Fallout 3. There's always a choice of betrayal. And last, although you should probably get it first, is the Broken Steel DLC. It not only increases the level capacity to 30, but it also adds a new ending to the main story, where you're knocked out for 2 weeks and the Brotherhood is mopping up what's left of the Enclave's forces in the capital wasteland. This yet again means you get new toys to play around with, and I don't mean just weapons level cap increase. Means that one of the new perks is the ability to get puppies! I of course mean the ability for dog meat to get resurrected, cause up until now I kept it in my house in Megaton. And on the general plus side for everyone in DC, the water is now pretty fresh. The very prime gets to be in the spotlight again, even if for a short while. And boy, how short. You can now have access to the Adams Air Force Base, which might explain where the Enclave always kept getting those vertebrates from. The two main new weapons that were great for me is the Tesla Cannon and the Heavy Incinerator. It has a cool effect with its long-range flame attack. There isn't much in the ways of new areas, you'll mostly be going through the wasteland, although this time, if you encounter an Enclave mind-controlled Deathclaw, he will fight for you if you take a certain device from one of the scribes. I kind of consider him a temporary pet, as in if you go too far from certain areas, he will die. Who's a cute little pet? Oh, yes you are! Yes you are! You're a cute little pet! Oh, yes you are! You're going to rip those nasty people into shreds, aren't you? Overall, there isn't much new here in this one to explore. To me at least, explored quite a bit. Didn't find that much new stuff. I did find out some new stuff, but overall, most of it was pretty standard what I've seen so far. Nonetheless. But I still enjoyed it nonetheless. Just for the level cap, it's definitely worth getting. Cause it definitely reignited my survivor. And be on the lookout for my Point Lookout and Mothership Zeta reviews coming up. Till next time. No wait. Till next time, children! Okay, that was pathetic. Goodbye.
Set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.